So you want to use ChatGPT to help you manage your project, and you type something like create a project plan for a new mobile app, and then you hit enter. Alright, and you get this generic textbook information with emojis, and that's why it feels like ChatGPT cannot work properly for project management, and you limit it to just drafting simple emails. The problem is in context gap. ChatGPT can't read your mind, it has no information about your project. That's why in this video I'm going to show you how to solve this problem with a simple method I call project context file. The secret boils down to one core idea, and that's the most important part of this video. You must start accumulating better context about your project. Project context file grows with every new piece of information you get for your project. And going forward, you must organize your work and meetings with this file in mind. So let me show you how it works. We'll start with a blank Google Doc, and I'll create the first tab here and call it Project Charter. And here's where magic will happen. The best project context comes from real project data. And we'll use here not just generic description of your project following the structure of the project charter. Instead, we'll use what every single project manager has nowadays. It's the transcripts of meetings with customer. All right, watch this. I'm going to use the whole transcript from a kickoff meeting with the customer. Then I'll use the role, context, task, and format prompting technique to generate a project charter. Here's the prompt I'm going to use. Role: you are a senior IT project manager. Context: I have attached a transcript of a project kickoff meeting with customers about the new product. Task: write a formal project charter. Capture all critical points. Don't allow any ambiguity in scope or requirements. Format: write in a formal tone, but use simple language and sentences. By the way, don't worry about writing this down or making a screenshot. I've put all these prompts in the description below this video. All right, let's put this prompt into ChatGPT and hit enter. All right, look at this. It cuts through the noise, it removed all the ums and ooms and all the small talk we had for 2 hours, and it captured the essence of the application we need to develop. And this is a great draft, the first draft of a project charter for you. Of course, you need to read and edit it and ensure that it's all accurate here, but here's the main point. You're not just leaving it here, you are adding this information to the project context file. So this is where the magic actually happens. This is the game changer for you. You are not discarding any piece of project information going forward. And every time you will use ChatGPT, you will attach this file and it will grow step by step. By the way, if you want to avoid this complex prompting and you don't want to get these generic answers from ChatGPT, I've got a solution. I've created a chatbot that is designed specifically for project managers. This chatbot knows everything I know and has access to all my materials, courses, and books. And it acts as your personal project management mentor. Check the link in the description below and start your 5-day trial now. So let's assume our project progresses and we had several more meetings with customers about specific requirements. So now we can use ChatGPT and our context to generate the requirements. I'll use the following prompt. Role: you are a world-class business analyst with 15 years of experience in the IT industry. Context: I have attached a file with all available project information as of now. Additionally, I attached transcripts of our meetings with clients about the requirements. we will implement the project in accordance with the best practices of Scrum framework. Task: analyze the information. For each deliverable, write the title of the epics. Ensure that you provide an exhaustive list of epics that cover all the required functionalities. Ensure that you break down epics in a way that covers only the current release. An epic should not spill over to the next release. Format: provide a plain list of epic names for each deliverable. Alright, I'm putting the prompt here, but notice that I've added the context file and I'm also adding the transcripts from our meetings with customer. And that's the way you organize your work going forward. You're thinking about how to input this information into an AI tool. Let's hit enter and see what it comes up with. Alright, this is a great starting point for organizing your backlog, for example, in Jira. Obviously, you don't need to use all these epics. You can select the ones that make sense, maybe group them, but take a look at the depth and understanding of all the deliverables and epics you need to create. But once again, the main point is that you want to copy the selected epic names and deliverables into your project context file. And you will create a new tab and paste it here, edit it out, leave only what needs to be implemented. And we can continue working with the requirements and start breaking down epics into user stories. I will use the following prompt next. You are a world-class business analyst with 15 years of experience in the IT industry. I have attached a file with all available project information as of now. Additionally, I attached transcripts of our meetings with client about the requirements. We will implement the project in accordance with the best practices of Scrum framework. Task: break down the following epic into user stories. Epic: implement user onboarding and registration. Write user stories using Kirkin syntax. Given, when, then. Follow the best practices of writing effective user stories. Format: provide the user stories in the following format: user story title, acceptance criteria. Okay, we can work in the context of all this information here. So I'll just put the prompt and see what I can get from it. Alright, this is a good starting point for the first drafts of user stories, and you can use them as is, copy them into Jira, and then edit the acceptance criteria, discuss it with your team members, and finalize the requirements. Now imagine you have done all this work, you created user stories in Jira, you wrote out the acceptance criteria and even got the approval on that user stories. Once again, ChatGPT doesn't know what happens inside Jira. That's why you need to export those user stories and acceptance criteria and add them back to your project context file. Alright, do you see now how it works? You should never start from a blank page with zero context. You should always attach this document to any new chat that you initiate. Now imagine you have this established project context file. Now you can start using it for more in-depth insights and strategic problems that, for example, a senior level project manager could find, but it has access to much more data than a human being can process. Let's put it to a test with this next prompt. Role: you are a senior IT project manager. Context: I have attached a file with all available project information as of now. Task: analyze the information. Brainstorm 10 high impact project risks. Elaborate on the nature of the risks and possible risk mitigation plans. Format: each risk should have a title, description, and mitigation plan. Format it as a table. Once again, I am, as always, attaching the context file and using this prompt. Let's give it a try. All All right, so let's see what we have here. All right, misconfiguration, access delays, and Azure quota limitation may stall OCR and backend services. Open API may be limited in availability, or in integration is impacting functionality. Okay, because I know what we discussed in those meetings, I can tell you for sure that ChatGPT has surfaced some problems that we didn't explicitly discuss. And for example, this one, receipts recognition may yield frequent errors or take too long, degrading the user experience, is a real issue, the real risk that we need to address somehow through user experience. So this is the real difference when you provide enough context to an AI tool. Instead of generic textbook information, it provides you with strategic insights about your project. That's the power of project context. And I believe that in the next few months or years, every single AI application will have an integration with some sort of knowledge management system that allows you to build better context for your projects. But here's a problem. As smart as these tools are today, they still do what you ask them to do. And at the end of the day, you are responsible to make the right decision based on the information they provide you with. That's why it's so critical today, more than ever before, to develop the practical project management skills that work in the real world with these new tools. That's why I recommend that you watch this video next, where I share 15 years of my practical experience leading IT projects. Click the video now, I am waiting for you there.